Welcome to functional fitness training. So what do you call it? For the veterans, welcome back. And then any new folks who pop on in, welcome to class. Today we are doing the workout is called ISO flows. And what we're going for in this format is we're going to hold like an isometric pose. And then I'm going to ask you to do work in that pose. So the key is whatever work you're doing is going to challenge your core to unstabilize or some part of the action. So we're going to really focus on alignment today. And the other things we're focusing on today is just shoulders. I've been feeling a lot of tightness up here. And so if you're feeling that's good, you will feel great after class opening up to the chest. If you're someone who has any kind of like carpal tunnel-y numbness sensations in your hands, wrists, or sharp shooting pains in your neck, this could be great for you because it opens up the chest. We've got a nerve that runs all the way from our neck all the way down to our hands. So surprisingly, if you're feeling any of that stuff in your hands, it's actually the tightness in your chest that might be causing it. But with that being said, nerves are sensitive, right? So if we're doing any kind of external motions or movements to the chest that you feel pinching or sharp shooting pain, I want you to back off of that and try something else. So that's what we got going for today. ISO flows, shoulders, back, and glutes. Let's go ahead and get started. Our timer's in the corner. We got 45 second rounds today, and they come in about four sets of four exercises. We'll get to all that. Let's just go ahead and warm up. Ooh, take a deep breath. Okay, team. So starting here, let's just swing. Oh, shake it out. Whatever the day has been, will be, we're just gonna forget all that and just move. So have your arms swing back and forth. Scrape that foot on the floor. Just really let that ankle flex and point. So it's flexing at the front, pointing at the back. There you go. Nice, other side. Swing, swing. And not only just play structures to help us swing, swing, we got our swing, swing legs. Hi, team. If you're just dropping in, light, medium, and heavy weights today. Okay, team. So let's start with a squat. Remember, we're practicing our ISOs today. So line up that knees, toes, hips back. And from here, I just want you to circle the arms. That's gonna have you have the tendency to wanna open and arch through the chest, lace that ribcage down to the hip, and just breathe. Feel that thumb going back, back, back. Arms go wide, 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 and then come back to center. Try to get that squat a little lower if it feels okay to you. You can always be at standing. And reverse it. So now, palms forward. Fingertips back like you're scooping ice cream with your hands up and over. Yeah, who doesn't need ice cream at 9 in the morning? There we go. Nice loose neck, long spine. Hold that squat. ISOs. All right, go ahead, shake it out. Come to the top of your mat, make sure you have room. Reverse lunge. Nice. Big stride back, most of that weight in that front heel, team. Beautiful, just open up through that hip. We're gonna do a couple more ISOs. So choose a side, any side, come to a split squat hold. And just like before, keep that torso center, but the arms are gonna circle. And bring it back to front. Circle back, thumb, 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 thumb. And bring it back to front. So we are just drawing that rainbow up and overhead and trying to keep everything down low and that neutral spine just out of the picture. Isolating. Good. And step forward. You can feel the blood pulling to your legs. That's the burn. Okay, switch sides. Same thing. Square up the hips. Slightly lean forward. Raise that rib cage down. Nice loose neck and draw that circle. Up, 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 back. So your thumb starts going back towards that back wall. And then you try to reach as far back as you can. Beautiful ISO lunge. Arms up and overhead. About 3 to 4 total. And then you can stand up and shake it out. Ooh, let's make our ankles a little bit. I know we're doing wrist shoulders today, but the extremities, other side, don't get a lot of attention, right? Big muscles groups kind of jump in and take over. Okay, now standing tall, no squat here. Take your arms together, hips forward, and I want you to circle that back arm and look back towards that back arm. I call these totem pole back reaches because I'm tall like a totem pole. My hips are forward and you're just reaching towards that back wall. And you can tell, and same arm repeat. As you repeat, that hip is gonna try to move. Draw that hip forward. So the hand that you're reaching back, draw it forward. Ah, there we go. Extra stretch through that side body shoulder. Other side. So I'm gonna turn so you can see. Hips draw forward, standing tall, reach. Up and over. Feel that chest open. Beautiful shoulder curl. Nice team. One more. Shake it out, crisscross. Hands behind the head. Now take that head and press it into the hands. Elbows go back, shoulder blades pinch, right? If you want, you can come to a mini squat here, but try not to change that upper body. Inhale, exhale. Rotate to one side. Inhale, exhale, come back center. Try not to yank on that neck. Make that rotation come from the center or the torso. Inhale, exhale, rotate. Other side. Woo. Inhale, exhale. So you're always exhaling on the pivot. Pivot. So we're doing a small squat. Pivot. And go ahead, shake that out. All right, team. So what I call those stargazes, it's really like you're pressing your hand into the hands and you're lifting up your chest. Let's try this again. Feet together, knees together. Zip up through that midline. Press your hands. Now just look on up. Your occipital bone or that curve in the neck is really pressing into the hands, and you're looking up, drawing up. Now come back to center, again. Inhale, exhale, look up, draw up, lift the ribcage, and draw it back down, again. Lift up, look up, and come back to center. Okay, team, kickstand, one foot front, one foot back. So this is the isometric hold that we're going for, right? You're slightly hinged back, your knees over your shin, light toe. Can we tap this? Yeah. That chest is directed right over that toe. And the reason why I'm going so in depth for this is in a second, I'm gonna ask you to do something that's gonna knock you off this position. So now, here it is. Hands behind the head. Lift the head, press it into the hands, elbows back. And I want you to circle the arms out to the side, up, and then draw it back center while keeping the kickstand. So again, you're drawing the arms to the T, go to an I, bring it back to the head, lift the elbows up. Again, T, I, hands behind the head, lift the elbows back. One more time, get the T. Get the I. Hands behind the head, pinch the shoulder blades, and stand tall. So the arms just went here, head, elbows back. All without trying to, without adjusting the ribcage. Other side. Okay, find that kickstand. Relatively straight front leg, light back leg, hinge at the hip, draw that ribcage down. Ribcage does not move here. Okay, let's try it out. Square up the hips, tap that toe. Okay, hands behind the head. Okay, press the head into the hands. Arms to a T, arms to an I. Bring it back center. I know, second set, a little wonky. Okay, T, because we've already been working it. I, hands behind the head. Lift the elbows, squeeze the shoulder blades, and one more. T. I, hands behind the head, and stand tall. Notice, shake it out. if you're feeling tightness through the neck. You should feel kind of more between the shoulder blades. And as we do our workout, be mindful of that. To the floor mobility now. We did all that stuff standing. We're coming down to the floor. So you can be kneeling or seated on a chair for this if it's speaking to your knees. We're gonna do very similar stargazes here. So hands up behind the head, lift the chest, and bring it back down. So we're doing everything again, but kneeling, because it's gonna take the low body out of the portion and we can get a little deeper into the shoulders. So hands, head, press the head into the hands, look up, ribcage lifts. Exhale, draw the ribcage back down. We're gonna do two more of these. Lift up, look up. Exhale, bring it back center. One more, lift up, look up. Bring it back center. Okay, facing me. You're gonna take your hands, make this. Hands behind the head, and you're gonna draw elbow circles. Now let those hands be loose. Ooh. So then now the hands move towards the ears. Elbows draw up, 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 and then down wide, wide, wide. Biceps are constantly flexed here. As you just reach the elbows narrow, narrow, narrow. And until they cannot no more, then you go wide. Feel the shoulder blades on the back end. So you're going up, elbows squeezing together, elbows wide, shoulder blades move together, and one more. Ooh, elbow circles. And relax. Okay, shake the hands out. So you remember those stargazes where we went, or we did the T's, the I's, and back to the floor. We're gonna have the opportunity to do that laying down. You can do that standing if you want. Wanna try that with me? Lay on the floor. Let's do it all again. Hands behind the head, lift the chest. This is the isometric hold. Hold the super person position. You're lifted and extended, spine long. Now bring your arms to a T. Bring it to an I. Hands behind the head and lift. Two more. T. I. Hands behind the head. One more. T. I. Hands behind the head and let it go. Okay. Coming down to all fours. This is for our wrists. That pinchy nerve stuff you might be dealing with or don't want. It's called elephant stomps. Two ways to do it. Either take the hands, this is the more aggressive stretching way, might feel good, or you're just gonna keep the palms down. So what you're gonna do, I'm gonna demo here. Elephant stomps, you're just gonna go bring your wrists all the way around. Let's try that. And then slowly, gently, go back the other way. So if you're someone who's already feeling wrist pain with that, I want you to go into these alternating stretches instead. I'll get nice and close so you can see. Hand, hand, down, down. Otherwise, we're stomping. Good. If you're diving a little deeper now, hands go underneath, and I want you to walk them around. I'll do it with you. One hand, lean back, alternate it a little further. Just explore. There's no really right way to do this. We're just opening up that wrist flexion. And other side, I flip my palm, I put it on the floor, I'm not putting a lot of pressure on it. Now, if you want, lean back, and you can start to explore how you move that wrist. Where do you feel that stretch? Good. Kind of feeling a nice stretch here in the back too as you explore. Woo, now everyone shake it out. So, this has taught us a couple things. So many ways to move the wrist and the shoulder. We're gonna explore that further. Now that we've opened up through the chest, we have this nice open posture that we're gonna reinforce by working our lats and our glutes. So that when we're walking through the day, we're feeling strong and upright, not so much like that. So here's the plan, team. You're gonna need on every single pod or loop of exercise, really light weights and really heavy weights. That means you're gonna be swapping a lot, but it's gonna be good. gonna be good. Let me demo the first four. Heavy. This is a gorilla row. You are in an isometric hold, gorilla squat, and you're rowing back. So your stance is wide here. Heavy, right? If you have two lighter weights, row at the same time. So that's number one. Number two is a hinge squat hinge. You're gonna take a heavy weight and you're gonna deadlift. Then you're gonna at the bottom of that deadlift, turn it into a squat, hinge back into a deadlift and come back up. So the ISO here is the squat lift. That's number two. Number three, you have the opportunity to do a double windmill. This is the light set. So the windmill, feet facing one direction, weights going high and low, bicep curl at the bottom, come on up. I really recommend light weights or no weights at all if you're trying it for the first time. Okay, team, so that's the team. That's the team, that's the plan. You are the team. All right, the song that just came on. Can't hold us. Okay, let's get it going. Gorilla rows, nice and heavy. Set one, 45 seconds to go. Ready, set, here we go. Wide stance, get down there, row it. Row it. You're in a squat, hinge position, single or double. Your hips are down, right? Not just the chest. Single or double here, right? Watch out for this. Try to drop the hips. You can be up here rowing. That's a beautiful gorilla row. 10 more seconds till we hit a single weighted hinge. Nice team. Oh, drop the hip. There it is. 3, 2, 1. Okay, one heavy weight. It's gonna be a hinge down into a squat, into a hinge, back up. It's a hinge squat sandwich. Two pieces of hinge bread, squat in the middle. Ready, set, here we go. Hinge down, at the bottom of that hinge, drop the hip, lift the weight. Oh, ISO. Then reset, again. Up, and reset. Try to always go through that hinge and return there. Whew. Nice. Just discovering the difference between a hinge and a squat. The hinge, the knee is above the ankle. The squat, the knee might come forward slightly, come back to that center, and come on up. Beautiful team. Down. Stand tall. Relax. Lightweight. Windmill. Double windmill here. Feet facing one direction. Bottom palm pressing into the hip. The shin. Straight arm. Pass that lat down. Here we go. Windmill at the bottom. Roll it up. Then come tall. Again. Nice long spine here. Hip hinges down. Inhale, exhale. Keep that core engaged on that curl. Stay on one side. So we are doing 45 second sets today, team. We will do this on the other side. You have 20 seconds to go. This is where you experiment with the weight, right? Keep that wrist over the shoulder at the bottom, right? That one should be over the shoulder. Yeah. 3, 2, 1. Bring it in. Other side, reset. You might feel that glute oblique working to stabilize. Point the toes other direction, hip goes opposite. Ready, set, here we go. Nice long spine. Find a place where you feel stable. Inhale, exhale, curl it up, come back center. Nice. At this point, I want you to come to a wood chop, right? We are working the obliques here too. Those are your options, right? Everybody got different wrists, woo, different hamstring flexibilities, go to the hamstring flexibility point where your spine is still long. Three, two, one, relax. All right, team, so those are our four. We're gonna do that all over again. The gorilla row, the hinge row hinge, the windmill. Everything is twice. You might see it again at the end. Everything is twice up front. So gorilla row. Okay, deep inhale. Shake it out. Gonna use our lats. It's round two. Ready, set. Here we go. Hinge row. Get down low in that squat. Double or single. Right? You could be squatting low, pulling in, or hinging. Elbows skirt the sides. Pull. Pull. Breathe. That's important too. Nice. Activate that front of the core by squeezing the hip bones together. Yeah. 10 seconds now. Good, team. Five now. Three, two, one. One heavy weight. Hinge squat hinge. Hinge sandwich. Deep inhale. Get ready. On your marks, get set. Single or double weights. Here we go. Hinge. Squat lift. Hold. And again. So all of the isometric moves, I want you to hold for a second. Get to that point. Count 1,000. Then move on. Slow, steady, build, and using our core to challenge the isometric hold. 10 seconds, 5 seconds, you got it, team. Last one, windmill, right? You've tried it once, we only do it twice. Maybe you try heavy, maybe you do wood chop. Switch it out. Set it up. Ready, set. Here we go. Up, windmill. And again. Keep that eye on the top weight. That will make sure that that wrist is stacked. Low body is doing the work to get you up. Oh golly. Adding like a pound more to this is so different. Second round, 10 seconds to go. And relax. This is where our friends who are like, I don't have light weights, are just jumping into the pool. Use your options accordingly. Maybe you're just going big today. That's good too. Ready, set, here we go. Windmill, with the eye on the weight. Curl it up. Then hips, glutes bringing you to standing. Long spine. Great top arm. Just work in. Isometric. Nice, team. 10 seconds to go. This is where it gets a little sticky. Breathe. 5 seconds now. And relax. Okay. That set is done. That set is done. We may see those again. But not right now. Moving on. Single leg deadlift fly. We're gonna get a lot of variety today. So we're not staying in one fixed pose and doing it four times. We do it twice, we move on. Lightweights here. It's gonna be a single leg deadlift hold or a hinge hold with a fly. What is the isometric? Oh golly, that beautiful single leg deadlift hold. You can be hinging holding, kickstand holding, or single leg deadlift. Some people like to call that T-top, okay? Each one of those is gonna challenge your core again, men, to not open up. Keep it laced down no matter what hinge you got. That is number one. The next one is a clean halo. Have a heavy weight nearby. You're gonna clean it up. Oh, I changed these. It is a clean press out. You're cleaning, pressing out. Squat clean, press it out. The isometric work is on that press out. I'll talk you through the next ones. Don't worry about it. Those are our first two. All 45 seconds on one side. Get your hinge, get your fly weights. On your marks, get set. Go, you got it. Everyone, we're hinging. Arm fly. Keep that hinge and just do the fly. So if you're doing that kickstand, it's just like that warm up. If you're doing that T-top, single leg deadlift hold, it is relatively going to your hamstring stretch point. It don't have to be all the way down here. I want the stretch of the leg and the hip even as you fly. Not about how low you can go, but that alignment. And relax. Heavy weights. We will come back to the other side after this. Let's get her heart rate up a little. Grab that weight by the top. Ready, set, grab it middle, press it out. Here we go. Heavy, catch, press, back down. Heavy, press. You always bring it back center before going down. If you have two light weights, you're going here, double press. Four, double press. Squat, double press. This is our clean press out. The isometric hold here is on the press out. You are holding a standing plank and asking your core to stabilize that load away from the body. Five more seconds, then we'll go back to those flies. 3 seconds now, relax. Light weights, single leg deadlift, fly. Woo. Nice long fly. Down. Getting started in 3, 2, 1. Squaring up the hips. I just say, the most I would want you to hinge over is about horizontal. So about here. Not a whole lot of benefit to going head below hip. Head, even a hip, is your range. Hold back. Try to drop that opposite hip as you fly. A whole lot of going on there. Okay, if you tumble a little. Woo! 9 seconds to go now. Woo! Then you're going to grab one medium or light weight. And relax. Do something you would do an overhead press. So grab that. We're going to do a reverse lunge. Press to start. Right. The hand that has the weight is the leg that steps back. Ready, set, here we go. Hand that has the weight, step back, press it up. You can be here, or you can do curls. Now, anyone who wants to try, lock it out and hold. Go back down. Again, I showed you 3 options: a curl, a press, a hold. Nice team, 20 seconds. This is the isometric work. I have to hold that weight up and overhead as I'm lunging back. That core shoulder is working. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Shake it out, other side. Woo! So, where did we start? We started with the reverse lunge and a curl. Or a reverse lunge and a press at the top. Reverse and press. If you want, do that straight arm lockout. Beginning in 3, 2, 1. I forgot to add one more. Okay, let's go. Reverse lunge, press it up. Warm up the shoulder. There's plenty of time to go up and overhead. Now, when we go up and overhead, I want you to do that without activating the trapezius. Here we go. Lock that lat down. If you want reverse, keep up that free arm. Yes. We are working the lat here. Great. Shoulder stabilizers, check. 5 seconds now. 3, 2, 1. All right, team, check it out. So those are our five exercises. Single leg deadlift, we did light. Clean, press out, we did heavy. Then we went back to light with the flies. Then we did some overhead press stuff. Probably medium. Goldilocks. Light, heavy, medium. Let's get started on those flies. Hinge it over. On your marks. Get set. So, line it up. Shoulder blades press. Elbows are soft but straight. Good. Head up. Nice long spine. Ooh, head about hip height if you can. But with that straight torso. Neutral spine. Beautiful. 10 seconds to go. Yeah, this is full body. You bet. Nice, team. Good. Keep it up. Good. 3, 2. And relax. Clean. Clean press out. Heavy. Doubled with the light flies, strengthening lats. Now that clean up, press it out. 4. Inhale, exhale. Here we go. When you're pressing out, you're keeping it about chest height. You don't have to go all the way to the end range. The further you move that weight away, the more challenge for the core. So do it if you're not feeling any of that back. Yeah. Use the hip bones together as you extend. That activates the low core. Nice. 10 seconds to go. This is our heart rate teaser. Yeah. Before we go back into that iso hold. And relax. Iso hold flies. It's a hinge fly. Ooh, face whatever direction feels good. Remember your options of kickstand. Big inhale. Let's dive in. Hinge, set it up. Ready, set. Here we go. Alright, take it 1 rep at a time. Drop that rib cage. Lace it to the hip. Good team. I know. So much love going on. Woo! Keep flying. Pull. Up and down. Pull. 10 seconds now. Oh, we're almost at the end. You got it. 5 seconds. 3 seconds. Oh, just holding on to that last one. Okay, team. Overhead. Light, heavy, or medium. We've seen it before. Remember, the weight is on the leg that steps back. Ready, set, here we go. Press it up, press it up. If you want, I'm gonna add that lockout at 30 seconds. So we have 30 seconds to go. If you want, go ahead, lock out that lat, straight arm, back. At 20 seconds, you can add an optional travel lunge, go back to center, go back down. Here we are. Travel lunge. What? We did not do that the first time. That's okay. Optional. 10 seconds to go. You could be holding it down here. Just adding a literal lateral movement. Woo! Relax. Okay. Second side. We'll do that same breakdown. 10 seconds presses, 10-second lockout. That's 10-second optional move. Ready, set, load up your side. Reverse lunge it. Optional press or curl. We're going to 30 seconds on these. Good. Use that front leg. 30 seconds. Lock out. Woo, pack it down. Are we ready for the travel? You travel to the side you're locked out on. Here we go. Travel squat. Not very low. Yeah. We're just challenging stability. That's all it is. It might be a little step. I feel like I'm dancing. 3, 2, 1. Whoa. That felt like a waltz. It might have been interesting for sure. Okay, team. Check it out. That pot is done. The beautiful thing, we're moving on. Kickstand land. So you're gonna grab a heavy to medium weight, and there's gonna be an option to swing in a kickstand. Two weights if you're not swinging. Let's talk about it. Everyone, begin here. Two weights in hand. I want you to feel strong in the kickstand first. So just like our warm up, most that weight on that front foot, light back foot. I can tell you, I see a lot of people, I can tell if your glutes working. This is what I look for. If you're here, you see how my weight is shifted back and I can't really lift my back toe without wobbling? That's a lot of quad work. I want glute work today. But if you're here and you can kind of lift that back toe, that is kickstand glute land. Yeah, so I just envision a laser coming down and going over my front toe. That is option one, double weighted. If you are feeling confident in that alignment with no back pain, you're gonna go in that kickstand, drop that weight between the hips, swing, swing. Now, the reason why I'm emphasizing alignment so much is if you're back here and you try to swing, you will get a little thigh knockage. But if you're hinging down, there is plenty of space for that weight to go, which is why I'd rather have you the first round clean up that alignment, second round swing. So, that is number one. Then we're gonna do a side plank with a row. We'll revisit the other side, side plank with a row. And then we'll do some super person iso bridge. We'll get there. Just focus on the deadlift. No need to get ahead of ourselves. Two weights if you're starting there. Ready? On your marks, get set, go. Kickstand. Kickstand. 45 seconds on one leg. Let that laser beam from the chest go right over the toe. The spine is not arching. The hip is just moving back. Nice, relatively straight bottom leg. Good. If at 20 seconds you're feeling confident that you're hitting that deadlift hinge and you want to explore, drop a weight. Here we are. Opposite hand, opposite weight. Hinge back, glute thrust. Yeah, it is that standing leg swing. Single arm swing, single leg swing. What is this? Kickstand swing. And relax. We'll have time to visit it. That arm that is not holding the weight, planking side plank. Arm that was free, put it down there. Here, light weight. Press it out, press it in. Ready, set, here we go. Out, in. Out, in. If you're not side planking today, I want you to do a external rotation here. So the palms facing the back wall. We are doing some shoulder rehab today. But don't you bet we are using our core as we do it. Whether you're side planking or hinge, because we're opening up. Remember our game plan? Opening up the chest, strengthening the shoulders so it stays open. Keep going, 10 seconds. Here, you can be on your knees too. 5, 3, and relax. Second side, kickstand. So we do everything on one side, we do everything on the other. Two weights to start. Kickstand it back. Let's check in with our alignment for 20 seconds. Ready, set, here we go. Go to the bottom. Where's that hinge? I'm standing. Try to lift that back toe at the bottom. Are we there? And hinge. That's one way to tell. Now, where's your chest? Ooh. Head up, chest up. Good. We're coming up on that 20-second mark, so if you're thinking about swinging, now is a good time to drop that weight and explore. Ready, set, here we go. Hand goes through the hip by dropping the chest. Post that weight on that front leg. Thread it through. 10 seconds to go. Hip action. Hip hinge. 3, 2, 1. The hand that does not have the weight is the side planking hand. Optional. Other hand has a light weight. I know, it's like a journey. Here we go. Elbow down. Side plank. Here we go. Align the head with the hip first. Elbow underneath the shoulder. Now, if you want, grab that light weight. It goes towards the tummy and brings it up. Or, like I showed you on the first side, out and in. Out and in. This is rotator cuff work. This is a little more chest press. Can be standing for these. Ooh. 15 seconds to go. Until we stay on the floor in 10 seconds. Yeah, and we're gonna do those T's, I's, and hands behind the back. 3, 2, 1, chill it out. So you'll be here kneeling or on your stomach. I'm gonna ask you to lift the chest, go to a T, I, hands behind the bed, and squeeze, just like our warm up. I know it's kind of hard to hear me when I'm down here, so let's try it. So everyone, on your stomach or kneeling, hands into the head, lift the chest, hold that, arms go to a T, I, hands behind the head, shoulder squeeze again, T, I, hands behind the head, shoulder squeeze again. So you really never come back down unless you're taking a break. You're in a super position where you're activating that low core, but that top chest is lifting. Arms T, scoop the sides of the wall as you're scooping up. Hands come behind the head, the shoulders, elbows tend to go forward. Get in back there and relax. Those are strangely painful, but so, so good. Come on up, we're gonna do it all again. Kickstand, starts with the kickstand. Ooh. Maybe you jump into the swing. Maybe you go heavy on that double kickstand. 5 exercises to go. Oh, hold on. Ready, on your marks, get set. Here we are, hinge, hinge. This is, we do it twice, right? So maybe you are going for that hinge, hinge. Oh, yeah, good. Nice. See where that weight is going. Is it not going between the thighs? That might mean you need to hinge more. Get that hip back. Nice. That's how you get it through. Yeah. 10 seconds now. Hip power. Stand on top of that front leg at the end. 3, 2, 1. Okay. Hand that's free. Goes down to a plank. Side plank it up. You decide if you want this extra option. Ooh, because side planking can be enough. Right? Here we go. Side plank up. 45 seconds. Beautiful. If you want, press it out in. Maybe you try a different rendition. In here, we're building shoulder stability. Woo! So fun fact, team, side planks is one of the highest ranked glute knee side glute activators. You might feel that from all the kickstands we just did. That bottom glute is probably on fire. You got it. 10 seconds now. Woo! Who's holding? Holding. Holding. 5, 3, 2, 1. Oh! Oh! Stand on up. Right? Other side, keep stand. The working glute is that front leg. So find that end range. set it up. Here we go. Swinging if you want. Watch where that back knee is going. You're doing the Elvis. Line it up. Keep it aligned as a swing. Take it slow. Nice. Outside glute working. Front leg working. Not about how high that weight is going to that shoulder height. Shoulder to thigh. Shoulder to thigh. Nice. 15 more seconds like that. Woo! You got it. 10 seconds now. Nice strong 10 here, team. Strong 5. 3. You got it. Good. And relax. Woo! Okay. Come down to the floor. If you were swinging here, this hand is going to the floor. This glute is going to feel on fire. Maybe. Okay. Side plank it up. Align the head with the shoulders. That might, most of us need to come back a little. Yes. Stack the hips. Now add on any lat and iso work if you want. Press out. Or tummy to shoulder height, external rotators. Or just think and hold, yeah. Oh! Ten seconds now. Beautiful, strong 10, remember? 5, 3, 1. Okay. The eyes, the hands behind the back. Let's really focus on the elbows back as we end and start. Set it up. Ready? Set. Here we go. Cover. Elbows back. T's. Eyes. Hands behind the back. Elbows reset. Again. Oh my goodness, team. This is hard. Woo! You got it. Or maybe we keep telling ourselves we got it. That works too. Woo! One hour at a time. Oh! I know. Just dying here. Whoa! And let it go. Oh my goodness. Those were kind of like laughable hard. Like when you're like, are you kidding me? Go ahead, towel off, wipe it off. We're gonna start cooling down now. Starting at this nice kneeling position, let's just go here. Shoulders up, throw them down. Up, down. Woo. Now, big shoulder circles. Let that chest go up and out, all around. Puff the chest out. And then drop it down. Good. Now we're gonna go to some cat-cows, that similar concept. Inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, curl it under. Again, lift the chest, curl it down. Woo. 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 Okay, team. Crisscross. So we are actually going to do this little funfetti type finisher. Then we're going to stretch it out. So we have finished the pods. Remember I said we might see a couple again? We've gotten to know these movements so, so good. It's going to be a 30 second set of each movement from the top. So that's going to mean 30 seconds of gorilla rows, 30 seconds of that hinge squat hinge, 30 seconds of all that other stuff too. So I'm gonna set a 5 minute timer. It's kind of like an AMRAP, as many as we can do in 5 minutes. That's about 7 exercises from the top. We're gonna start there. Getting started, let's stand tall, heavy weights, gorilla row. Yeah, we're gonna do it again. Setting it on up in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Where are we? Yeah, take your time getting there, you got it. Now we're on. Remember when we were dropping the weights, hugging the elbows to the shoulders? It's like a little finale through. We've worked the shoulders up, down, side to side. Let's just give it a little bit of a hello party send off. 5 seconds now. 3, 2, 1. All right, hinge, squat, hinge. So one heavy weight or two. We're hinging, we're squatting, we're hinging. 30 seconds. Beginning in 5, 4, 3. And here we go. Hinge, squat, hinge, stand tall. Again. Keep going. It is going to be quick transitions, but we don't see them again. 10 seconds now. Woo! 4, 3, windmills. Light. Feet point one direction. Here, curl, back up. 5 seconds till we begin. Getting started in 5, 3, 1, here we go. Ha, hold look, curl, back up, hinge, hold curl. One side, all 30 seconds. I know, some of us might be at single weight, bottom loaded. That is a beautiful, gorgeous place to be. 10 more seconds. This is the finale round, that enjoyment lap, right? 3, 2, everybody enjoying how we focus on finishing our exercises. Maybe hitting that alignment. Maybe giving up something extra. 5 seconds to begin, we're switching to the other side. Set it up. 3, 2, 1, yeah. This is the lap that you do because we're a team, right? Most of us, including myself, might have been like, I'm good after the first set. So we keep each other going through the finale set. Nice. Windmill. You got it. Three, two, one. Bring it back. Hold on to the single light weights. Hinge fly. Beginning in 10 seconds. Shake it out. 5 seconds. Ready? Set, go, here we go, hinge fly.
Smoking chill. It was on the gym at lunch. We thought it was real. I was even falling math. I ain't
good. Just 10 seconds now.
It worth it. I dropped out.
You got it.
Still sounded perfect. I remember at the
bar. 5 seconds. 3, 2. Shake it out. Other side. Okay, team. We're in that home stretch. We're going to finish this leg. We're going to come down to the floor and we're going to do those super circles. Getting it started. Second side, second leg. Hinge it. On your marks. Get set. Here we go. Fly it out. Beautiful stability through that bottom leg. Nice, beautiful, gorgeous spine. Long. Head lifts it. Yeah. 10 seconds now. Woo. Shoulder blades. Go, go. 3, 2, 1. Weights down. Finish in 1, 4. Last set. Last 30 second set. Here. Tease. Eyes. Back down. You can do kneeling too. On your mark. Get set. Here we go. Hit up. Chest up. Here. I. T. Elbows back. I. Hands, elbows back. Keep going your pace. Like you're swimming on that top end. Three, two, one. Child's pose and dab back. You are done. We are stretching. Drop the head, drop the chin. Hold the child's pose. Just breathe. Woo, big inhales, expand the chest. Big exhales, let it go.
You're the one, you're the one. Stand it down.
other side. Walk the fingertips.
Soldier on, just keep on fighting.
Drop the head.
Without you, I'm so incomplete.
Big scoop, big lift. Oh, let it go.